first thing. I don't want it to say, I'm not giving a criticism of, oh, geez, it's not democratic enough. So that's the first part. On the vision for the future, I'd say communism, right? I mean, that's, and I think of communism as from each according to ability, to each according to need. It had the basics would include the abolition of private property, the collective ownership of the means of production, the collective determination of our collective conditions. So that would be the, and what's the rallying call for that? The rallying call is an emancipatory, egalitarian future. Is there a place for violence? Well, I mean, I guess the way I would put it is, I can't think of a place where there's not violence. I mean, that violence, and there was a, something like Monty Python line, it's an error in the system. So violence is, the violence is all is an unavoidable aspect of our conditions. So I don't know if that's something kind of distinctive to, or a repercussion particularly of what I'm saying. I mean, I'm talking to people who are politically involved, politically engaged. So I'm not really worried about, you know, trying to speak to absolutely everyone in the world. That would seem like that's a kind of crazy fantasy of what it is to speak politically. I think one speaks politically, one speaks to a subset of Americans, some kind of population. That you imagine politically engaged and listening, not people who you don't imagine as politically engaged and listening. So with the discussion must stop, what I would say, the way I think about that is, since at least Seattle, people involved in left media discussions, that everything has been indie media. Right? It's like everything is participatory democracy, citizen journalism, indie media, that's the way of the future. What is that? What is that? What does that mean? It's meant the denial of class conflict. It's meant a paving over of neoliberalism as if our conditions were those of participatory involvement in this system. And what the repercussion has been justifying, legitimizing, protecting this system of neoliberalism and austerity. So with a shift in focus to better goals, right? What is our goal really participation? Or is our goal actually bringing down the governments that are redistributing wealth upward? Does that answer the question?
The critique of social media as the sort of fog into which social protest disappears runs the risk of becoming a self-fulfilling prophecy. So I would say that as well as noticing those on the street, let us also notice those who are supporting those on the street. And I'm thinking of the recent example of Turkey, where, as I understand it, people who perhaps were at work during the day or were frightened, when they got home at night and opened their doors and windows and banged the pots and pans, which, as I understand it, was an action in support of those on the street. So I think it's important to notice, always to have a habit of trying to notice what is happening and not what is not happening.
I think it's a beautiful comment. I think the people banging pots and pans is absolutely great. We could also add to that the people who had clinics for protesters in different buildings nearby. We can add to it the people who would provide lemons and water for people to get rid of the tear gas in their eyes. So there's a huge realm of material support that you're absolutely right bears your attention and acknowledgement.